Chef Ramsay arrives looking to find out why Amy's baking company needs his help.
We love desserts.
Hello. Hey, Chef!
How are you?
How are you doing?
Nice to see you. First name is?
Sammy.
Sammy, good
I'm
to
the
see
owner.
You.
You're Thank
the owner.
You. Yes.
Wow. Look at that. Come on.
My wife, Amy, yeah.
Can I meet this lady?
Yes, now.
Please?
Yeah. Amy?
Yes?
Gordon Ramsay wants to meet you. He wants to know who is the chef of who does all this beautiful.
Come round, please. Come round, my darling.
So nice to meet you.
I'll give him a hug.
Did you make them?
Yes, I did.
Incredible.
It's nice to meet you.
Likewise. Good to see you. I mean, they're extraordinary.
Thank you. That's very nice. It means a lot coming from you.
Any of that stalwart?
No.
The restaurant is beautiful.
Thank you. And I want you to see my kitchen after or before as you want, and then you tell me about our kitchen also.
Right. Show me the kitchen.
Okay.
Please.
Excellent. I don't mean. Okay.
You got me excited. Sorry.
Of course. Thank you.
Okay.
Please.
Oh, my God. Okay.
Who's the head chef?
I am.
Hold on. Stop. Stop. Holy crap, you got lucky.
I'm the lucky one. He is my soulmate, and we're in this business together.
Fine,
and we stand strong together. We have to because there's a lot of online bullies and haters and bloggers. We stand up to them, and I think we're the only ones that ever have as restaurant owners. And they come and they try to attack us and say horrible things that are not true. Because they're used to eating processed wood chips or used to getting things for free and not from us.
Okay. Let's catch up with the haters and that stuff.
After you.
Can I have a quick look at the kitchen?
Of course.
Normally, owners don't like it when I inspect kitchens, but the floor's shiny. It's like a basketball court.
Come, please come see. If you're not,
my goodness
me. You want the jacket? No, you don't need it. You don't need it.
It's like a doctor's surgery in here.
Yes, thank you, thank you. Thank you for saying the truth.
Oh, my goodness me. Is this a joke? I mean, look, dates, labels,
yes, everything,
sectioned off. Wow, what a pleasure. Hello.
This is Miranda.
This is Miranda. She's going to serve you.
Nice to see you. And this
nice
is
to meet you. I'm Katie.
This is Christine. She's my
Christine,
wingman.
Come over, darling. Are you the sous chef?
She is.
Let's go through the dining room.
Okay.
The restaurant itself is very clean and nice, but it's Amy and Sammy that are the problem. Do not judge a book by its cover.
So, take me back to the beginning. How long have we been married?
Almost 10 years.
Oh, yes, no.
We got married 5 months after we met.
Wow.
Well, I prayed for him and God sent him to me and I wasn't going to waste any time.
She said, forget you, Sammy Hafner, enough.
He was a playboy in Vegas.
You were a playboy in Vegas.
Oh, my God.
Wow.
He was.
Seriously.
He was. Even Hugh Hefner didn't have as beautiful of women as we did. All the playmates would come to our table. He was a playa. But with me, it didn't work like that. I am individual or nothing at all.
Once we got married, that's everything out.
Wow. So, were you trained in the industry?
No, not at all. I'm a developer. I build custom houses.
Oh.
But when the crisis started, I said, I still have money. What do you want me to do with it? She begged me. She said, my dream, it was to open a restaurant.
Mm-hmm. I just, throughout my life, had a passion and a God-given talent for it. And this is all I want to do.
That's lovely.
Thank you.
And the ganache as well.
Thank you.
That's beautiful.
Mm. Oh, God. I'm the only one that makes them. And if I'm not here working, we're not open.
Say that again.
If I am not here, if my husband's not here, we're not open. We don't run without each other here.
You're kidding me.
No.
That's no way to run a business.
We can't find qualified people to work. They want to come and get a paycheck and not work.
In Arizona?
They're not good. I tried a lot of them. This is my biggest worry. This is my biggest problem in my life.
But
I cannot find people. I can count on them. I can trust them.
They're dirty. They're lazy.
How many people have you been through?
A lot.
A few hundred.
A lot.
A few hundred?
Yeah.
So other than an issue with staff, what's wrong with this bloody restaurant?
I have issues with customers that are trying to be online bullies and say horrible things.
Online bullies?
They're online bullies and write things that are not true. They write that I have store-bought dough. They write that things are frozen. I understand that, but those things are not true.
But when did this start?
2.5 years ago.
This guy came in that started this entire online bullying.
He ordered pizza margarita. And after I say, okay, how is your pizza? He say, it's a frozen pizza. The next day he went and gave us a review. My God. My wife, she was...
Well, retaliated.
You wrote back to him?
Oh, yeah.
Right. Well,
why?
I told him. I thought he was a loser. He was a moron.
No,
I didn't
take
him. I understand. He insulted me first, and I attacked back. I'm not going to let anybody bully me, bully my husband. That's a joke.
You need thick skin in this business.
Well, they called me Crazy Amy B because I stood up to them, and I need people who respect you, who know that you have earned your stripes in the kitchen and in life. I need them to listen to you and not the online bullies and take your word that you're saying that our food is good.
Amy, if all your food is as good as it's deserved, trust me, there's something not quite right here.
Thank you.
Are you a control freak?
I am.
Is it?
We are enemy worst.
What a combination.
We have to clone us.
Clone us.
Is that possible?
It is, some places I've heard.
Right. Do you have children?
Well, we have three little boys, but they're trapped inside cat bodies.
Yeah. They're cats.
Our babies are cats. They're my whole life, besides my husband and my business. I speak feline. Meow, 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 meow.
Meeting you two for the first time, you are both nuts.
I know.
I'm gonna have a little sample of the menu.
Okay.
Do your thing normally.
I will.
Hello.
How are you, my darling?
Good.
Is it just you and Sammy in the front of the house?
It's pretty much just me.
Now, how long have you been here?
A month and a half.
Good tips?
I don't make tips.
Say that again.
I make hourly.
Serious? You must be the only server in this country.
I know.
That doesn't get tipped out. So where do the tips go?
The owner.
What?
Yeah.
I can't believe that.
I know. I try to tell him.
Wow. Okay, great. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Sammy. You spoke earlier about the problem with staff. Yeah, I've just found out something pretty major. Miranda, the young girl?
Yeah.
You don't give her tips?
No.
Sammy,
yeah.
You cannot take servers' tips.
Then bring me the people who's going to do their job and I don't have to interfere. They can take the whole tips for them. Did you see? I already took three orders by myself and sent them already to the...
You're the owner.
I'm doing the most of the job.
Wow. I'm ready to order.
Okay, I'll take your order. Do you know already what you like
to
start?
Yes, I do, yes. Yeah. The fig and pear prosciutto pizza, please.
Excellent.
Yeah, and then I'm going to go for a blue ribbon burger. Medium rare.
Medium rare. Excellent.
Please. And I'll take the salmon burger as well at the same time. And then I'll fancy some gnocchi. All the pasta's homemade, right?
It is, but not the gnocchi today. It's not homemade. We didn't have time to make them.
Okay. I'll go straight to the ravioli.
Okay, which one do you like?
The red pepper.
Perfect.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
The story is becoming a little clearer.
Okay, Amy.
Yeah.
This is the chef's order.
Oh, God, okay. I believe that once Chef Ramsay tastes my food, as a chef, he'll be able to tell that this is what God wants me to do.
What's that doorbell? It keeps on going off every 2 minutes. Miranda. What is that doorbell on the side of the wall for?
Whenever we have dirty dishes, we ring it, and then the busser comes and grabs the dishes from there.
Why would you walk around and just put the plates in the pot wash? The first time in my career, a pot washer has a doorbell. Oh, ding dong.
The large or the small?
Small. White three cheese pizza.
Ah, the cheese pizza.
Sammy.
Yeah.
Does Miranda use the POS system?
No, she does not yet. Nobody's. I'm the only one who uses it. Yeah.
But the quicker you teach her, the quicker you can take her back and seat.
I will teach her when you come the time. I will teach her.
Miranda, have you ever worked on a POS system?
Yes, at every job that I've worked at.
Every job. And how many jobs have you had before you worked at ABC?
A lot.
A lot. She doesn't need training. She knows how to do it. Thank you.
Oh,
yeah. It's for. Yes.
Thank you.
I'll get you a plate.
The fig and pear and prosciutto pizza. Well, the crust is supposed to be good, but it's not that crusty. It's very, very sweet. My dough's raw. After all this wait. Wow. That is so sweet. But that's not the issue. The issue is the dough is raw. I feel it. It's raw. It's doughy.
I don't know how we come out today like this, but normally they love that pizza. It's really, really lovely.
I'm telling you what I'm getting, and it's raw, soggy and wet, and too sweet in general.
We'll take that off.
Can you take it back to Amy, please?
Of course, yes.
Thank you.
Oh, my God, I don't think you liked it. What's wrong?
Nothing.
I feel like Sammy sugarcoats a lot of what happens in the restaurant, so Amy gets this feeling that, like, everything she's doing is correct, everything's right.
Don't worry, don't worry. Everything is okay.
I'm not worried. I'm afraid he's going to say something isn't good.
I know my wife. She doesn't take the criticism. She will be shaking, and then she say, that's it, I'm leaving. Just, I'll tell you all about it after. Just relax and do like you do normally. Just do it.
Oh my God, I'm going to freak out.
Chef Ramsay has been sitting at the table for well over an hour.
I feel it's raw.
And so far, all that he has sampled is an undercooked pizza.
I don't even tell her you didn't like the pizza.
You didn't even tell her the dough was...
Not yet. I know my wife, she'll get nervous.
You're scared of telling her the truth?
Do you want to tell her? Come with me, you tell her.
I just wanted to know so she checks the next
one. Okay, she will know, yes, she will know.
Anyway, I am 75 minutes in, and so far, I've had an undercooked pizza.
I know you've been waiting.
I'm going to start eating my ticket in a
minute. Oh, okay, I'm going to tell her you're starving. I'm going to tell her you are starving. Okay, she'll move, okay?
She'll move.
I hope so.
You know where that goes. Yes?
Okay. Thank you. Wow. Blue cheese, mushrooms, marinated, garlic aioli, white truffle oil, and crispy bacon bits, and a soggy bun that's just full of grease. Come on. I have a lot of nerve calling this their blue ribbon burger. Well, medium rare, it's not. Ooh. What? It's just a mess. Oh, dear. That is overcomplicated, so unnecessary. And look, that is one burger.
It's
a disaster. Yeah, the bun. What a mess.
Okay, so, yeah, so I'll take this back.
Really disappointing. I am starving.
I got it. Thank you. This is for him? Yes, red pepper ravioli.
Thank you.
Red pepper ravioli. There you go.
How's the salmon burger doing?
I'll go check on that.
Thank you.
He wanted to know how long in the salmon burger.
It's on its way.
Okay.
You don't need to keep reminding us. We know, okay?
I was just saying.
I know, but you don't need to come tell us. We know that it needs to go out.
Oh, my God. It smells weird. Oh, here's my salmon burger. Wow. Thank you, Dave.
You're welcome.
Oh, God. Sweet, spicy. What a mess. Be one of the most confused ravioli dishes I've ever seen and tasted in my entire life. Wow. It doesn't make sense.
Doesn't make sense, huh?
Sweet and spicy.
Yeah.
Ravioli with bacon and sweet corn topped with cilantro. Are these store-bought?
Yes, the ravioli, yes.
You told me that this was store-bought, then I wouldn't have ordered it.
Ah, okay. I didn't tell you. No, I didn't tell you that.
Thank you. Look at this thing here. This is what I've been waiting for. So it's like a salmon cake, crab cake, burger. It's overcooked. I mean, it's not good. Although it may be good for those three boys, three cats at home.
Do you want me to take that?
Please, because it is. Like eating dry cat food. Do you want to take a sample?
No, I really don't.
Come on. Meow, meow. Is Amy there?
Yeah. Do you want to go into the kitchen?
She can come out now.
Okay. I'll tell her.
Just a quick. Amy?
Yes.
That was a lot longer than I expected. And, you know, there were some big bumps in that meal.
What kind of bumps? What didn't you like?
Let's go through it later.
Okay.
I'm going to go get changed.
Okay.
And I want to see how this place functions. And then after service, cover all the points.
You look disappointed.
I am disappointed.
Okay.
But let's go through this later.
Okay.
Yeah?
Of
okay.
Course, yeah.
Sure.
This is what you are here.
Yes. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
That's for you.
Oh, thank you.
You only.
Thank you.
Me.
Okay.
Don't worry, don't worry.
I'm not worried.
No. Never mind.
Drink.
You do. And you do what you do. You accept this, do what you do.
I'm concerned with his opinion.
He loves
the
desert.
I understand.
Please do me a favor. You can. They are good.
Okay, listen. We're going to start to get ready, you guys. We're going to open.
How does the line work? Who does what?
Christine does mostly the salads, and I do the pizzas. I have people tell me it's the best pizza that they've ever had in their life.
My pizza today was undercooked, so it was raw, and I said, will you take that back? He said, I can't talk to him in service. Why is that? You're a husband and wife.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not as if you're sort of manager and assistant manager. So why can't you go and tell your wife?
Because
sweetheart,
I know my
pizza,
wife.
Wake up, is undercooked.
I don't think your pizza was undercooked. I checked it when I took it out of the oven, just like I do every other pizza. And to me, it was crispy on the bottom. When I cut it, it was crunchy.
Okay.
So to me, it wasn't wrong.
Okay, so that's your version, because you didn't see it come back. However, the bun for the beef burger was soggy as anything. Blue cheese, marinated mushrooms, crispy bacon bits, white truffle oil. Who comes up with those ideas?
I did.
Because there's certain things that don't go together, and that's four of them.
Chef Ramsay is standing there riding my ass about white truffle oil and garlic aioli. Oh my God, like he's never heard of any flavor profile in the world. It's disgusting. I have never had a problem with that hamburger, ever.
Because your husband doesn't tell you. And the salmon burger was like a salmon fish cake in between a dry bun.
But it was a dry bun or it was a soggy bun?
That was dry. Dry pate, dry.
It's good like that. We have people tell us all the time that it's good.
There's no point in me saying anything to you because you just don't. Where it's good like that.
Whatever.
The raviolis, do you cook them from frozen?
Yes, we do.
Do you know how you can make these better?
What? Yes, I can make them from scratch.
No, take them off.
Oh, yes, of course. Why don't I just delete everything from my menu?
I'm just trying
to. And then close my doors. What do you want me to sell?
These are store-bought, crap frozen ravioli.
They're not crap, and they're delicious, and I, the first time I've ever cooked.
Oh, my God.
Did you taste it? You didn't taste that one.
I can't, because you didn't get the feedback. I said they were disgusting.
People usually love it. I've never had a problem with it, but.
People usually love it.
Yes, real customers, not haters.
Oh, come on, Amy.
Raviolis that are in the freezer, oh my God, sacrilegious.
Ladies and gentlemen, 2 seconds, please. The owner is trying to pull the wool over your eyes by offering you frozen raviolis that aren't even made within 500 miles of this front door. So would you mind, personally, if I 86 them to stop you from eating crab? So we'll 86 ravioli.
Okay.
I have too much respect for your customers to them. Now, will you tell your wife or shall I?
It's dinner service, and Amy continues to deflect everything.
The owner is trying to pull the wool over your eyes by offering you frozen raviolis.
So to make his point, Chef Ramsay decides to do a little research with the customers.
Would you mind if I 86 them? Are you going to tell your wife, or shall I?
I will tell her.
Thank you.
Okay, listen.
Yeah.
No more raviolis.
No more raviolis, and no more hamburgers, and no more salmon burgers. People can only have cakes tonight.
Okay.
Okay, I'm good with that. Complete.
She can't take criticism. Why is that?
Ask her that question.
Ask her?
I have the same problem for that.
Are we used to waiting on something?
Yeah.
What is it that you're waiting on?
Pasta.
Spicy pasta. The pasta resica?
Yes.
Is that coming? Can you look on B4 and see what else they had? They should have pasta resica.
No, I don't have it. You didn't give it to me.
Sammy.
Yeah.
Sammy, I did write it down for you.
Oh, it was here?
It's right there.
What is it?
Pasta rustica.
I see it here. Yeah. It's okay.
4B. No, 5B. Are you sure? You don't need to question me, Katie. You can go home right now.
I'm sorry.
Sammy?
Yes, darling?
I would appreciate it if you would send Katie home right now.
No,
I don't need an
okay.
attitude from her. She comes and she said,
it's because there's the two others.
Oh, my God. Am I sure?
What a little...
Amy,
I'm not going to talk to you right now because I have to concentrate on the line.
Stop. Concentrate then.
I will. There's no point in talking to you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
And the pizza?
Food is leaving the kitchen at a snail's pace. And it doesn't appear to be worth the wait.
You can take this back, too. You didn't like it? Okay.
When food's not eaten, do they tell you?
No. Every single time a customer doesn't lick their plate, the waitress doesn't come to tell me that.
Amy, no one's licking that.
Just ignore him. I am ignoring everything that's happening.
Stop. Thank you, Amy. Excuse me. So, that just comes back from the table, and it goes straight into the pot wash.
Then they didn't like it.
So, if they didn't like it, what are we going to do about it?
Let's wait. We finish today.
The kitchen needs to know.
Okay. Then I'm going to tell her.
Thank you.
Okay. Amy, this is the salmon. They didn't like it.
For me, this is all
I don't care.
None of you had known about this because the young girl, Maria, grabbed the plate and was about to throw it away. That's a common thread in this restaurant.
There's no point in me speaking, so wow. I'm just going to work. It's like one long nightmare.
Wow, $10 tip.
Yeah.
That's nice. For you?
Of course, yeah. Why not?
Do you think the girls deserve some tips tonight?
No, they get hourly.
And so do you think if I went and asked every customer, when they leave a tip, yeah. that it goes straight to the owner and not to the server? Mm-hmm. Do you think they'd be astounded? Let me ask that table there. Sir, the tip that you left, the young lady server, the owner takes the tips.
That's horrible.
No, okay.
Don't with me.
Yeah, I will with you. Yeah. Who the you think you are?
Oh, my God, Sammy's going to hurt him.
I'm fed up. I'm getting sick and tired of your Well, then answer my question. Tell the customers they're going to get yeah. their tips.
No, they don't.
They should be told that you're taking them
yeah.
because this server deserves yeah. them.
You want to speak with me?
Yeah, I want
you
to speak
with you.
I will with you.
Oh my God, what a joke.
Has everybody got this food?
Yeah, we're closed. We're closing the kitchen. I think, Katie, you can go. For sure. I'm talking to you, Katie.
Okay.
Katie, listen to me when I'm speaking to you. Do not walk away from me. You don't work here anymore, okay? Don't start crying. She comes to the kitchen tonight. She's like, I set a table. She said, are you sure? Are you my boss?
It's okay. Katie, please. No, come on.
She doesn't work here anymore. She's a poisonous little viper, and I don't allow people to have an attitude in my restaurant. What does she know? Who the hell is she? She is gone. That's who she is.
Don't let the door hit you on the way out.
Tonight, Chef Ramsay witnessed how dysfunctional Amy and Sammy are at running their business.
Katie, you do not work here anymore, okay?
Including firing Katie for simply asking a question.
Now, you've just fired a young girl. Mm-hmm. But just take a big deep breath and see if we can get some form of resolution here.
Okay.
Believe it or not, my intentions are good. You're shaking your head already.
I'm listening.
It's become evident that you can't take criticism. Why is that?
Are you seriously asking me why I'm so good?
Yeah, I am.
You don't have to cry. You don't have to cry.
I'm not going to cry, Sammy.
Just cry.
I'm trying to speak and take
quiet.
Out my
a
conversation. No one lets me speak. Ever. Nobody. Oh, my God.
Let me talk.
I know that, but you're not listening to me.
I know. I listen to you. We listen to you.
He asked me a question. What I do normally is good. I don't have people sending things back to me.
You don't know, Amy.
You're saying that
you don't know. Because food comes back, it goes straight to the dishwasher. That's what the whole issue is. You've been avoiding everything. Behind your back are the most amazing desserts. And in your freezer is store-bought raviolis that you're never going to convince me or a customer that they're good.
The sauce is delicious. The raviolis, we think that they're very good.
What I'm struggling with is that you convince yourselves that it's right. It's not. Tomorrow, I want you open-minded, okay? You as well, Sammy.
I don't make promises that I know I can't keep. I'm going to do everything within myself to try.
All you're getting from me is the truth. Right now, that's what you need. Good night.
Good night.
Yeah.
After one of the most difficult days he has ever had on Kitchen Nightmares, Chef Ramsay has arrived with a plan to start turning around Amy's Baking Company.
Oh, come on.
But with Amy and Sammy not at the restaurant, he takes the time to meet with former staff members that have reached out to him.
Morning.
Hello. How are you both?
Good.
Jessica, right?
Yes,
good to see you.
Henry,
nice to see you. First of all, Jessica, what was your job?
I was hired as a food runner. Sammy told me that he didn't like people who went to culinary school because he didn't think that we knew anything. And when I started, I was only allowed to pour water glasses and set them at the table. So I worked up front for a few months and basically had to beg my way back into the kitchen.
Unbelievable. Henry.
I was a busser for the most part.
How long ago were you there?
A little over a month.
And what kind of things did you see in the dining room?
He was always in a bad mood, no matter what. Like, I've never seen him in, like, a good mood. He can't take complaints in, like, a professional manner, which is the worst part. He made me wash his car one day.
What?
That was the most ridiculous thing I've ever done for him. They were always yelling at each other.
In the year and a half I was there, I saw at least 50 people come and go.
50?
They were in and out so fast.
Wow. What happens when customers complain about their food?
They get told that they're wrong, that, you know, no, we have the best food in the country. You're wrong. Like, there have been times people have gotten salmon that's raw, and they'll send it back saying, you know, can you cook this a little more? And they're like, you don't know how to eat food. You don't know what you're doing. This is perfect. You just, you obviously don't know. Customer's always wrong there.
That is insane.
It's just that they don't really know how to manage a restaurant. I don't know what it is, but they both think that, like, the whole world is out to get them.
Listen, I appreciate the feedback.
Yeah, no problem.
You've been very helpful, and I appreciate the honest truth.
Absolutely.
Wish me good luck. I need it.
Yeah, good luck.
Absolutely,
with
good luck. Hope we can help them.
Thank you. Wow. It gets worse. Morning.
Good morning.
Morning, Sammy. Today is a new day.
Yeah, I hope so.
You don't look very happy.
Yeah. I'm exhausted. Can't. It's all, yeah. Never had this experience like this. It's disaster.
Okay. I've never had an experience like this either.
We want to clarify a few things.
Please, should we sit down?
So there's no animosity,
Let's
of course.
Sit down. Let's clarify a few things. What would you like to clarify?
What I have a problem with were the comments you were saying to me last night while I was trying to focus on the food.
Let's look at one thing at a time and be open and honest.
Okay.
Okay. Because for me, this was about uncovering the truth. When I'm told that the raviolis are freshly made...
I didn't tell you that.
Can I finish? Sorry, when your husband told me that the raviolis were fresh, I ordered them. And the raviolis were disgusting and not fresh. And if you're going to try and continue to pull wool over customers' eyes by sending them fake... fresh-made raviolis, they need to know.
That sends my alarm bells going.
Just speak a minute.
Now, you may want to sit there and argue, but you're not prepared to understand that I'm here to show you what's right, and you can't take that.
I can. I'm ready for that. I have no problems with the food.
I told you about the burger. You refused to listen.
I did not. Every time I tell you something, what was wrong with it?
You come back with an excuse.
I kept asking you what's wrong, and you couldn't give me an excuse.
I told you. The bun for the beef burger was soggy as anything.
I have never had a problem with that hamburger, ever. You said the salmon burger was dry, but it was wet. Is it dry or is it wet? Which one is it?
One at a time. No, you're confused. I'm not confused when we're talking about food. But the way you screamed at that young girl last night...
Would you let anybody come into your restaurant, in your kitchen, and speak to you the way that kid spoke to me last night? Would you? Do you think we're going to let someone hold a gun to our head and we're going to give them our ass and let them do anything they want from us?
All she asked is,
No, she did it with an attitude, a serious attitude. She's like, are you sure? 4B.
Are you sure?
You don't need to question me, Katie. You can go home right now.
No, she didn't.
Okay.
Now you're over-exaggerating again.
All right.
But you'll blame her and you'll blame the customers. But customers were waiting for the food through your husband's mistake.
But okay, we're going to forget yesterday.
Right.
We're going to start, if we continue the show, we're going to start from scratch.
I want to forget the word show. This is not a show for me.
No, I mean, I don't know what you
call it. This is a restaurant that is in crisis with a delusional owner that can't take criticism. So I'm going to tell you as it is. I met Jessica and Henry this morning, and I got told some awful things.
Like what?
The way you treat staff. They have to clean cars in the middle of service because the boss wants his car cleaned. And then witnessing over 50 staff being fired in that short period of time.
Really? 50 staff?
50 staff.
You're saying that I have fired 50 staff since Jessica
was here?
You're saying that?
I am.
Can you prove that to me?
Here we go again.
50 staff?
Look at your eyes.
That's because you're saying lies.
Look how bitter you are. Have you not had a turnover of more than 50 people?
She was wrong. 100 or even more than 100.
Wow.
Yeah, not only 50,
so
100.
So the stats are actually worse than she told me?
Yes, it's worse, yes.
Could you tell your wife that? Because I don't think she knows.
It is.
I need a drink of water, excuse me.
You're going to run off again?
Yesterday, I didn't even eat or drink, and I have to drink water. Are you going to attack me for wanting to drink some water, too? My God. I don't even know why we came back here. I'm going home.
This morning, Chef Ramsay arrived with a plan on how to turn around the restaurant. But the owners wanted to clear up a few matters.
Now, you may want to sit there and argue, but you're not prepared to understand that I'm here to show you what's right.
Unfortunately, they are still not prepared to listen to what Chef Ramsay has to say.
Excuse me. I need water. Yesterday, I didn't even drink, and I have to drink water. Are you going to attack me for wanting to drink some water too? My God, I don't even know why we came back here. I'm going home.
Now you're going home?
This is such nobody even is listening to me. They're going to go by Jessica. This, oh my God, unbelievable. These people are incredible. And I've had enough and come here to be abused in my own restaurant. I want to go home.
Just cool down, Amy.
All we've done, all that's happened is we have been attacked.
Attacked. Why are you behaving like
because
this?
Because I'm insulted. You verbally insulted me yesterday, and I held my tongue out of class. I didn't tell you the truth. I didn't say nasty things to you.
Really?
Okay, really, I didn't, really.
When I told you about the burger, you refused to listen.
You don't understand. You're judging me on you coming in here, disrupting the entire service. I've been doing this.
Disrupting?
You did disrupt us last night. How could I focus when you're on
my
food?
What about my lunch?
When you're standing here talking to my husband. What about when I cooked for you?
Who disrupted you then?
Everybody. What are you talking about?
Blaming everybody again.
I do my best so our business doesn't close because we can't find qualified people. You go get Miranda and that little Katie and Jessica, bring them here and let me see how they work.
They won't come back.
Will you do that? Of course.
Oh. Do you know what? They're scared of you.
They're scared.
And they're embarrassed. But unfortunately, you've convinced yourself in your little Amy's world that everything you cook, touch, send is perfect.
I do not. What? Am I arguing?
Garlic aioli goes well with white truffle.
Well, let me show you some. Can I show you reviews? Hundreds of reviews that are excellent that you didn't write that
not
are from real customers.
On the internet again.
No, good reviews. Real customers that have supported us for 6 years.
Look at the way.
You're attacking my business and my life. This is all I do is live this life every day. You're not telling me the problems. You are saying I'm delusional. I'm this. Can we talk about what we came here to speak about, please?
Yeah, let them finish. I want them to
You told me to be honest.
I am always
about
honest.
The problems that you've had, that you cannot talk to your wife, and the issues that she can't take criticism before I met
her. That's fine. I have no problem saying that.
That's fine. I think you're too far gone.
Okay, then let's end the show. You think I'm too far gone? There's no hope. Yalla, yalla. It's Christmas. Let's go home. Okay.
I can't help people that can't help themselves and cannot ever take 1 ounce of criticism. And if you're not willing to change, I'm not gonna butt heads, argue, scream, whatever you wanna say. But this is not normal. And it's not normal for a restaurant to go through that many staff. It's not normal for a kitchen that small to have 65 items on the menu. And it's not normal for the level of animosity that you've built inside this restaurant and outside. You have the right to run the business the way you want to run your business. I have the right to do the right thing. And the right thing for me is to get out of here. Good luck. Wow.
It's good.
It's
what you wanted.
Yeah, of course that's what I wanted. Participate in this. Give me a break. Can they take this thing off me?
We don't need his help. Maybe he knows that.
It all has to come down.
And now he's gone. He walked away. He'll go on with his life. Sammy and I will go on with our life.
Well, it's finally happened. After almost 100 kitchen nightmares, I've met two owners who I could not help. And it wasn't because I didn't want to. It was because they are incapable of listening. And in a short period of time, they've managed to piss off the community and go through over 100 employees in 1 year. Sammy and Amy continue to blame everyone else, yet their biggest problem is themselves. And I know whatever changes I would have made, they were never going to stick to them. And that's why I've decided to do something I've never done before. It's such a shame.